Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 has a lot of new features, and I wanted to share with you five of them that you might not know. And the first one has to do with photos. Now you can use even an older device. The oldest supported device is a 6S or a 6S Plus that I have here. And if we go into photos and then we edit a photo, what you can do is tap on the little crop button here, and you have a couple new options. And this has to do with perspective. If you hit this little button here and use this little slider dial, you can adjust perspective. So maybe we want to make it look like we're looking top down, and then we can adjust it horizontally from the side, however you'd like. And then when you're done, if you're happy with it, hit done and it saves. Now, if you want to revert back, you can do that. Hit revert, go back to the original. It takes a moment and it will go back to what it was before, and you didn't lose anything. So it's really nice. It's a little hidden feature there and helps specifically with people if you're adjusting perspective. So that's really nice. Now the next feature is kind of interesting and one of my favorites that's pretty well hidden. Now Shortcuts is installed with iOS 13 by default. So if we go into Shortcuts, we can create an automation using an NFC tag. So maybe we want to automate something like turn off Wi-Fi, as you can see Wi-Fi here. In fact, I'll go into settings and show you this. We'll go into Wi-Fi, you'll see it's on. If I bring over an NFC tag, such as this amiibo, tap it on the back here, it shuts off my Wi-Fi. So you can program different NFC tags. Now, amiibo have NFC tags built in, so it works very simply because of that. But if we want to create another one, we hit the plus, create personal automation. Then we scroll down to settings, tap on NFC. Then we scan an NFC tag. So in this case, I have a Yoshi amiibo, tap it on the back, and then we can name it. So we'll name it Yoshi, hit done. Then we'll hit next. Then we can add an action. Now under the action, there's a bunch of different things. We'll go to apps, and under apps, we have a bunch of different actions we can perform. So maybe we want to go to weather and get details of weather conditions, and you'll see get details from weather conditions. We'll hit next, we'll hit done. And if we bring this NFC tag close to the back, it should give me details of weather conditions. Now, all of these do not work 100%. Sometimes it works well, sometimes it doesn't, and it depends on what audio it's using at the time as well. But you get the idea. You can set up your different automations to use different NFC tags. They don't have to be amiibo. They can be any NFC tag, and you can just tag those and change lights or anything you can do with Shortcuts. You can have it do automatically. So that's really, really interesting and should be really nice once iOS 13 has a lot more Shortcuts. Even though there's a lot, there's going to be a lot more with this update. Now, if you're like me and you use Safari all the time, you're probably going to have a bunch of different tabs open. Well, if you don't want all of those open, which they can be using memory in the background, if you don't want all of those open, all you have to do is go into settings. We'll go down to Safari. And under Safari now, if we scroll down, we can close tabs manually after one day, after 1 week, or after 1 month. So we can change that depending on what we want it to do. I changed it to after 1 month. It's set to manually by default, but I changed it to after 1 month. And if I haven't used those tabs within a month, it will just close them out after a month. So it's really nice, very simple, but nice to see. Now, if we're in the App Store and maybe we have an app, let's turn on Wi-Fi again. Maybe we're in the App Store and we go to our updates and we see an app that we don't use a whole lot anymore. Maybe it could be anything here. Let's see if we can find one. Maybe I don't want to use this one. I can just slide it over, hit delete, and it's gone. So we no longer have to find the app wherever we put it. We can just simply slide over, delete it, and get rid of it. It's a nice little extra feature in case you see something that you're updating and you didn't realize was there. Now, speaking of apps, this should help a lot of people that don't have access to Wi-Fi all of the time. So again, with apps, if we go to settings, and then we'll find iTunes and App Store. Under iTunes and App Store, there's now a little tab here that says app downloads. We'll tap on this and it says ask if over 200 megabytes, always ask or always allow. If you don't care about a data cap or anything like that, turn on always allow, and you can install apps no matter how big they are. You should be able to install those. It says allow all apps to download automatically using cellular data. When roaming, permission to download is always required. So it will allow you to do this now, and you can no longer have to wait until you're on a Wi-Fi connection. Unfortunately, they haven't done that for updates just yet. Now, many of you are familiar with this new setting in the battery. If we go into battery and then go to battery health, there's optimized battery charging. Now, when you have this turned on, when it's actually working, some people have seen a little pop-up that pops up and lets you know it's working. So that part's really nice. It's just a little extra thing there that you can see. And then finally, I wanted to share with you that they've improved search a lot in iMessage. So if you go into iMessage and then you pull down from the top, you have a little search box. Type in the search box. If we type in Google at the search box there, you'll see it gives us a little contact. If we have a contact, it gives us all of the information in our conversations and also links to different things with the word Google in them. So it provides all of this information that's here that wasn't there before. It works really well, and you can search any word from a conversation that's there and then go directly to that conversation if you want to see that. So it's really nice. Some really simple updates that they've done that should help quite a few people with different things, anything from shortcuts to editing photos. So let me know if you have any other hidden features that you haven't seen yet. I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. I think those are all pretty good, and I'm sure there's a lot more. So let me know if you'd like to see more of these videos in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more videos like this as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.